Hey everyone, so today we are going to answer this question. So given eigenvalues and eigenvectors in a given problem, question is how to find the matrix. Okay, so this is a very nice and you can say one of the important application of diagonalization. What is diagonalization and all those things, I have already gave a talk on that and the link you can find in the description. But let me just briefly recall it. So a square matrix A is said to be diagonalizable if A can be written as PDP inverse, where D is the diagonal matrix whose diagonal entries are nothing but the eigenvalues, and P is a matrix consisting of eigenvectors. Okay, and we also know that all square matrix are not diagonalizable. Under so and so condition, they are diagonalizable. And one of the condition is, if your A is a matrix of order n cross n, then when this is diagonalizable, provided you have n linearly independent eigenvectors. So whenever you have n linearly independent eigenvectors, your matrix is always diagonalizable. Okay, so this is one thing. Okay, now let's directly jump towards the question. So now here is the question. You have to find the matrix A whose eigenvalues are 1, 2 and 3, and the eigenvectors are this, this and this respectively. So for 1, eigenvector is this vector. For eigenvalue 2, this is the eigenvector. For eigenvalue 3, this is the eigenvector. You want to find the matrix A. Now good, you have eigenvalues. So you know, we know that by diagonalization, A is equal to PDP inverse. Where what is D? It is the diagonal matrix whose diagonal entries are nothing but the eigenvalues. So eigenvalues are 1, 2, 3. I usually write in the descending order, because the highest eigenvalue are of pretty much important. I mean, if you study data science or machine learning in future, then you will see that highest and the smallest, these two eigenvalues usually play a larger role. Okay, so my D is this. Okay, now question is, first of all, is your matrix A diagonalizable? That means whether you can write A as this decomposition? Answer is yes. Why? Because A is a matrix of order 3 cross 3, because as you can see, the vectors of order 3 cross 1. So this is 3 cross 3, and as you can see, these three vectors are linearly independent. Why so? Because if you recall a nice theorem from linear algebra, eigenvectors corresponding to distinct eigenvalues are always linearly independent. So eigenvalues are distinct, yes, therefore the corresponding eigenvectors are linearly independent. So therefore, for a 3 cross 3 matrix, we are having 3 linearly independent eigenvectors, and therefore the matrix is diagonalizable. That means A can be written as PDP inverse. So what is my D? It is a diagonal matrix whose diagonal entries are the eigenvalues. What is my matrix P? It is the matrix whose column vectors are the eigenvectors. So first I have written 3 over here. So first the eigenvector for 3 will come, then 2. So then the eigenvector for 2 will come, and then 1. So eigenvector. So this is my D, this is my P. Now what is the next step? You need to find P inverse. So I have calculated P inverse. So let me write it down directly. So our A is nothing but PDP inverse. So I wrote the matrix P, the matrix D, and this is my P inverse. You can calculate and verify. Okay, so now first I did this two matrix multiplication, which is this entry. 110 into 300 is 3. 110 into 020 is 2. 110 into 001 is 0. So you do this multiplication and P inverse is as it is. And then you do this two multiplication. And therefore, this is the required matrix A. You can check that. You can try to find eigenvalues and eigenvectors for this matrix. You will get the same answer. 1, 2, 3 as the eigenvalues and this 3 as the eigenvectors. So this is one of the very important steps. So whenever there is a question on finding the matrix of whatever order, say 4 cross 4, 5 cross 5 and so on, and it is in the question, if it is given that these are the eigenvectors. So just see. If matrix is 3 cross 3 and 3 linearly independent eigenvectors are given, go by this way. If matrix is of order 2 cross 2 and 2 linearly independent eigenvectors are given, good, you can apply this. Okay, so that's how one can solve such kind of problem. Now let me give you one homework question. So your job is to find the matrix A, eigenvalues are 0, 0, 3. So for 0, these two are the eigenvectors, and for 3, this is the eigenvector. See, when the eigenvectors are distinct, you are not supposed to worry about the eigenvectors because eigenvectors are linearly independent for distinct eigenvalues. For repeated eigenvalues, now they have mentioned two, that means it has to be obvious that these two are independent. But just for safer side, you can cross-check also. Because for here, the algebraic multiplicity is 2. So geometric multiplicity has to be 2 for the matrix to be diagonalizable. That means for the matrix to be rewritten as PDP inverse. Okay, so for that I should have GM to be 2. That means I should have 2 linearly independent eigenvectors. And you can check that these 2 are independent. Here there is a 0, here there is a 0. That means you do C1 times this plus C2 times this equal to 0. Your C1, C2 will come out to be 0. So these 2 eigenvectors are linearly independent eigenvectors for eigenvalue 0. And this is independent for this. So overall these 3 vectors are linearly independent. And now your job is to find the matrix A. So write down the matrix D, write down the matrix P, find the matrix P inverse and do this multiplication. PDP inverse, you get the answer A. The only thing one has to be cautious is if you are writing 0, 0, 3, then write down the eigenvectors for 0 first. If you are writing 3, 0, 0, then you write down the eigenvector for 3 first and then for the 0. Everyone should get the same answer. So I expect someone to comment the matrix A, either row wise or column wise. So I hope you understood that how to find the matrix given eigenvalues and eigenvectors. So I hope you understood this. If yes, do not forget to like, share and subscribe. Thank you.